So we're here with Zach with Huskie Landscaping. And so Zach, are we in a drought?
We're always in a drought. We're in Utah.
Okay, so I guess we're hoping for a good winter this year, but we're not sure just yet, right?
Yeah, everyone needs to either pray for snow or just hope for snow, I guess.
Okay, so let's say we don't get snow and we have another bad year. Let's talk about Xeriscaping and what that might look like.
The best thing is just remember that we need to conserve water. Uh-huh. We're in a desert. Everyone knows that. We talked about that before. And we want to design accordingly so that if there is a drought year, we can cut back on water, not have to watch all of our money go down the drain in dying because they're not getting the water that they need.
Exactly. Now you have a project that you were just working on where a lady wanted to do a Xeriscape, right, as they call it, and there was some sort of issue or something. What was that?
Yeah, the neighbors, you know, didn't like it.
They didn't like the idea, right, because they didn't know.
Yeah, it's just, I think they were ignorant to the fact of what it was and, oh, it's not the typical grass everywhere and, you know, kids running on it. She is a single lady. She doesn't have the budget to be able to maintain it or can't do it herself. She has health problems. Uh-huh. So she wanted to put in a Xeriscape so that she could save money on water and she could, you know, save money on maintenance also.
Yeah, because she wouldn't have to take care of it, right?
Exactly.
That's beauty with it.
The neighbors even went to as far as getting a petition together to send to the city so that they would stop it. And the city was like, what are you guys talking about? This is what we want. We want you to do this because, you know, we're in a desert and we want to conserve on water.
Now, this was before the fact, though, right? Before it was done. This was kind of the idea. They were just so fearful.
Yeah, it was in the process. So she was coming to me going, I don't know if we should keep doing this. We need to go. I'm like, no, just keep doing what we're doing and just wait and see what happens.
And so what happened?
So the city actually gave her an award for the Clean and Beautiful Award of West Valley City.
Oh, really?
And, you know, they...
And so how are the neighbors feeling now?
I think they're eating crow. I
mean, they are?
They can't really say anything.
And we've actually got some... You know, we're actually showing it on the screen there so you can actually send some pictures. It's absolutely beautiful. You did a great job. And so is it like a typical job? Or because Xeriscape can come in so many different... I mean, it can be big rocks and small rocks and...
Yeah, typically Xeriscape's a little bit more as far as like budget's concerned when your initial install, but you're gonna save money. She's probably already paid for the project two or three times over in water savings.
That makes sense. So you pay a little bit up front because you gotta pay for all the design and all the rocks and all the stuff that you put in there, but over the time you don't have to maintain it. You just cut down on all the lawn care. I mean, just the mowing the lawn every day or every week, I guess, in this case, right? I don't mow every day. Some they do, I know, I see some of those laws, but then you don't have to worry about all the watering too, and so it theoretically pays for itself.
It does, over time it really does.
And so are you doing more of these now, or what
yeah,
you
we used to, you know, 10 years ago we'd do maybe one a year, now we're doing one a month maybe.
Oh really?
Or not, the one you saw was a full-on 100% Xeriscape in the front yard. Uh-huh. But you can incorporate some of those design elements in your landscape and not have to do all just rock mulch and plantings that would just be drought tolerant, but you can add in some areas that you could enjoy but have that same theme and
so you can mix and match.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's a great idea. Because I know I had a half acre when I lived down in Linden, and it was a nightmare. I mean, to try and maintain, that's all I did. I used to like to go out in my boat, and I never did anymore because all I did was maintain that big yard.
Exactly.
It was horrible. Yeah. So yeah, Xeriscape would have come in handy.
So you kind of have to, you know, match your personality and see what you need in your landscape. And that's, you know, we sit down and have that consultation and see what.
And this is what you guys do. You go in and design it and help them see the big picture.
Exactly. And you need to remember, though, it's not for everybody. Yeah. Like if she tried to resell her home, she's only going to attract a certain demographic of people that would want that in their yard.
But she could go in there and modify it afterwards and then add some grass or something, right?
Yeah, a little bit. You could. But like in her yard, she kept her backyard just a normal standard landscape. Mm-hmm. But she cut her water bill in half, basically, by doing that.
Which was good for her.
Yeah, exactly.
But you can always, it's like anything else, you can redo it if comes time to resell, right?
Correct.
So you're gonna design it for yourself and then redo it.
Correct.
Well, you always do a great job. I really enjoy having you on the show, buddy.
Yeah.
So if somebody wanted to get a hold of you, if they wanted to Xeriscape or do anything having to do, because you do everything, right?
I do.
You were just talking about building decks and stuff.
Yeah, right? We do. I can't say I because all of our
we
crew.
Say we.
Yeah, exactly.
But you're the head, like main guy, right?
Exactly.
You're the boss and
I'm
main
the man.
Employee. Okay, but you point them in the right place. The head laborer, is that what you like to call it?
Yeah.
Okay, so if they wanted to get a hold of you, how would they contact you?
Just they go to huskieslandscaping.com or they can reach us at our phone number, 801-712-2575.
Great, buddy. Thanks for coming on the show.
Appreciate it.